I must now unveil a secret which is rarely revealed when people are first learning about antiderivatives. Well, consider, for example, the function f of x equals 1 over x. What is the general antiderivative for this function, right? What's the most general thing that differentiates to 1 over x? Well, I know an antiderivative, log of the absolute value of x. Well, that's right, because the derivative of log absolute value x is equal to 1 over x. So an antiderivative of 1 over x is log of the absolute value of x. In fact, I know some other antiderivatives as well. For example, the derivative of log of the absolute value of x plus 17 is also equal to 1 over x, right? Because the derivative of 17 is 0. More generally, the derivative of log of absolute value of x plus some fixed constant is equal to 1 over x. So this is a very general antiderivative for 1 over x. But there are many, many more antiderivatives where those came from. For example, here's another one that doesn't fit into the pattern that we've seen thus far. We'll define a function big F, and I'll define it using this piecewise notation, right? So if x is positive, the function big F will be defined to be log x plus 17. And if x is negative, the function will be defined to be log of negative x plus 20. And in fact, the derivative of this function is 1 over x. So this is an antiderivative for 1 over x. The upshot here is that the constant could be different to the left and to the right of 0. So the most general antiderivative of 1 over x is a function of this form, right? Big F, log of x plus c if x is positive, and log of negative x plus d if x is negative, just for some constants c and d. We can see this in a graph. Well, here I've got a graph of y equals log x, and here I've got a graph of log negative x, and the point is that I can move these two graphs up and down independently without affecting the derivative. No matter how I move these graphs up and down, the derivative is always 1 over x. I mean, if I just move this thing up and down, it doesn't affect the slopes of the tangent lines at all. If I move this piece up and down, it doesn't affect the slopes of the tangent lines at all. And I can move them up and down independently because I don't really have to line up at all, right? I mean, since the function's not defined at 0, I don't have to worry about making them agree anywhere. I just slide them up and down fully independently. And nevertheless, the derivative is always 1 over x. One way to summarize this is as follows. So suppose that f is a function with an antiderivative big F. Then any other antiderivative for little f has the form big F of x plus c of x, right? C is not a single constant anymore. C is some locally constant function. The point is that this so-called constant could be different on different pieces of the domain. Just like in this example with 1 over x, the constant can change on the right and the left-hand side of 0. Here's the sad, sad truth. In spite of all of this, some textbooks nevertheless write that the most general antiderivative of 1 over x is log of the absolute value of x plus some constant c. So all of this provides a sneaky way out. Now, this is perfectly fine, right? So this is fine, provided what? Provided that c isn't a constant, but c is a locally constant function of x.